Hello, Reformers, and welcome back to Nova Aetas. Now, if you're looking for amazing deals on games, the weekly sale at g2a.com has just begun, so check it out in the link in the description. So, yes, when we left off, we were being chased by some Mithridian vassals, the scoundrel, fiendish people. Yes, we're not very happy with them. And, obviously, obviously took back Tardis by forcing them to surrender, basically. Well, technically forcing the Saranids to surrender, because they took that for some reason. But anyway, we have now moved. We have moved our focus from attempting to make inroads on the Saranid mainland, and instead we are going to try to eliminate, or do our very best to eliminate, the Mithridians, because, well, they're being quite a pain in our side, and the Saranids aren't actually that difficult, the Mithridians aren't actually that difficult, but for the most part, what we're going to do is try and take out these two vassals here before we head to the nearby castle, and the nearby castle has about 280 units in the garrison, and I'm a little bit daunted by that, I gotta say. I mean, I think there's quite a possibility for us to have some rather devastating losses, and that's kind of a bit of a shame. Now, what I have done is you remember that I took a bunch of recruits and footmen and other things out of the garrison from our home base in the Aztec territory. Well, technically it's our territory now, but still, the point is we took out all those units and we had them all in our army, and well, we were, you know, going to transport them to the garrison, and, well, what I've done is I've just swapped those out for the veterans that I previously left in the garrison at Terragrit, and now hopefully we're going to be all good. Oh, I do need to stand closer a little bit. Oh, no, that's a little bit late. Isn't it? Yep, it was a little bit late. My bad. My bad, but it's okay. It is okay, because all of our Huskars will absolutely destroy every one of these lancers, I hope. The lancers are very good, do bear that in mind, and obviously they're even better now that they are on even ground and actually able to use their mounts, because before that it was just blank and blade rather than mount and blade. So yes, it is, yeah, it's a lot easier for them now, but yeah, at least we don't have any cavalry to speak of so that their pikemen cannot do anything to us, so it's actually kind of nice. Well, they can kind of, obviously, still do damage and things, but it's going to be a lot harder for them to do that, because obviously with horses, it complicates things a little bit, and I'm going to try an experiment here. Ah, okay, so apparently, when you heal your men, when you inspire them, it does not matter whether you're standing close to them or not, as far as I'm aware, because as you could see right there, all of them cheered. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but that seems to be the indicator to suggest that the heal actually did go off. So that's pretty nice. That is pretty nice, because I was wondering whether they did it sort of fantasy Calradia-like, where the faith spells that you get in that when you play as a cleric or a paladin or something along those lines, I wondered whether they would be proximity-based, the same abilities that we have here. So yeah, that's actually really good to know. So that means I can basically cast it wherever, and we will be in an extremely strong position as a result of that, because I don't want my forces to die, obviously. No one wants their forces to die, and I'm gonna try my very best, obviously, just to limit the amount of damage we take, but obviously it doesn't matter how much damage we take, because we can heal for 42 HP, which is really insane. I would love to be able to heal for a flat value for our army, but obviously it's just a percentage base, because most units, you know, it's for balancing purposes, because most units will not have as much HP as we do, obviously, but yeah, hopefully once we get that technology increase, they might actually be able to start getting a little bit more survivable, and they'll maybe be a bit harder to kill, but for the most part, I think it's a balancing reason, of course, because you don't want your, well, you don't want your recruits being healed instantly, and instead it's a 30%. I mean, three heals, you know, heal a unit back to full, so it's pretty reasonable. So we did lose four units, but that's absolutely fine. And as you can see, we do get to take them prisoner once again, which is actually really nice. I like taking them prisoner, but we have so little. We have so little food. It is not going to go well. If this food does not sustain us for our entire attack against the Mithridians, it's going to be painful, to say the least. Okay, so we are on the, well, shall we say, outermost corner of the Mithridian Islands. I decided to attack from here because there are two castles within range. And I didn't really want to go for Mithridius immediately, because this looks like an extremely difficult siege, and I'm pretty sure it's going to be extremely difficult. So, yeah, we're going to go for those two first, and then we're going to push on, maybe take Corinthus as well, and then go for Demetrion, or whatever it may be, pronunciation-wise, and then we'll eventually go for the town, but I don't know whether we're going to do that either. It's all up in the air right now, and my plan is just to stay alive and do our best. So let's see what we can do here with Quinius. Well, he obviously could use... What could he use? He could use some more intelligence? Oh, no. I suppose he could. But then we'll get him a little bit more in iron flesh as well, just to make it so that he's a little bit harder to kill. Obviously, right now, he's pretty easy to kill, so... Yeah, Matteld, not so much. She's actually pretty tricky to kill, so that's kind of nice. We do need a little bit of an influx of companions. I think we need a couple more, so I'm going to try and find some of those if I can at some point, but obviously not right now. Everyone is at war against us, so it's not very good, but other than that, we have leveled up as well, so I suppose it's about time that we start to level our agility. Now, we do have an opportunity to go for some more power strike here, but of course we have other things to do as well. I mean, we have surgery, we have first aid, we have wound treatment. We even have pathfinding and trainer. I mean, trainer is kind of pointless. Kind of. It's not actually that pointless because obviously it does reduce the amount of days that you have to wait for your recruits at the varying castles that you capture, obviously. So that's actually kind of good. But other than that, I'm not entirely sure. Should I get some riding skill? Let's get some riding skill, and I'll show you why in just a second. I hope that I'm doing the right thing here. If I'm not, then so be it. But let's just have a look here. Okay, yeah, I was doing the right thing. Now, sway-backed horses are very, very slow, and I'm hopeful that this will make us a little bit faster. We lose a little bit of armor, but other than that, we gain some maneuverability, and we gain some speed, which is always nice. So, yeah, the horse loses a little bit of armor, but that's fine. I don't think that's too big a deal. So, without further ado, are we going to execute all of these vassals? I don't know. That's the thing. I don't know. I think right now what we're going to do is just head in here and see if we can build these ladders before we have any kind of retaliation. Ah, that's a little bit late, I think. We are going to get attacked by that fellow there. So how much money are we making right now? 172,000 for our kingdom. As you can see, our research is going quite nicely right now. We have 318 against 1,000. It's going to take a while. It is going to take a while. Ah, we also have this guy who has apparently just defected to us, and I obviously can't change his title right now, which is kind of a shame, but our investments are actually doing quite well. 55,000 right there. And obviously the most we're getting is from our towns, so that's pretty nice. But yes, this guy is going to attack us. Not entirely sure why he would decide to do that, but I suppose it's because he thinks he has a chance, which is, well, quite frankly, delusional, because we just beat two vassals, but obviously they had about 60 and 70 units respectively, and this guy has about 110? 105? I'm not entirely sure, but yes, I don't think he's going to be able to stand up against us at any point, unless he has a different army composition. It seems as though they have a couple of ranged units, and it didn't seem like the previous army had any of those, so, well... That's interesting. Let's see whether they can muster anything to try to defeat us. Now, obviously, as you can see here, we're riding a different horse, and it's making quite a bit of difference in the way that I play this, because obviously now what I can do is try and distract most of the cavalry. I'm going to tell our people just to charge in here. I'm going to try and lead them on a merry chase. Wild goose chase. In this case, a wild diggery chase. But, yes. Is a wild Diggory going to appear soon? I don't know. But yes, hopefully not dead. Hopefully not dead. So yes, this... Is this looking good? I don't think this looks good, actually. It doesn't seem to be looking good. I don't know why some of our Huskarls are being a little bit antsy here. They seem to be just running around randomly for some reason. They seem to be splitting up and all kinds of things. I don't know why that happened. I told them to stand closer, but apparently some of them thought it would be a good idea to stand in a very stationary position while they fired off their javelins, which usually would actually be kind of good and helpful, but in this case it actually made things a whole lot worse, as all of our enemies were able to pick off the single units, which is never a good thing, obviously. They do have crossbowmen. They do have crossbowmen. We didn't actually see many of these in the previous fight, so I suppose, well, we're gonna see how they're, you know, they're not very good. They are not very good. So, yeah, I'm actually kind of happy about that, obviously. Yes, if they had way too much armor, then this would be very, very difficult, but thankfully it seems as though they can get taken out in a very, very short amount of time. I'm going to try and heal our people right now. It's maybe a bit late, but I don't know. I don't know. I mean, that's the thing. Like, we're fighting these Imperial Guards, and they have some pretty decent gear, but they're not anything to worry about in comparison to our Huskarls, but they just have numbers. And our Huskarls are kind of doing some weird formation stuff here. I mean, yes, I know, I did tell them to charge in, and usually that will separate your units somewhat. But as you can see, some of them are just kind of standing back here, not really doing much. I mean, yes, they are firing with their thrown weapons, and that's perfectly fine. But if they could actually hit with them, that would be a little bit better, wouldn't it? Yes, it would. But yeah, anyway, we're just going to have to deal with the losses that we incur here. Really? Did I really miss that? Okay, let's do this. Yes, that's what you get. Shot in the back. Very honorable. Well, what am I saying? We're a villain, aren't we? Yes, we're a villain, so I don't think it's... I don't think it's a bad thing to shoot someone in the back right now, at least. So, yes, there is one that is going to escape, which is obviously a little bit disappointing. We must have complete domination over the enemy. And there's 11 renown. So we're not gaining any more morale right now, which is actually kind of good, because that means obviously we're maxed out. Because I was a little bit worried about that, considering we had a food shortage. But other than that, there we are. Another Earl has been eliminated, and we are able to take him prisoner. I think I'm just going to amass a bunch of Earls, and then we're going to see if we can maybe then capture some Jason Lees. Do you get it? I don't know whether you get it, but anyway, what I do know is that we're going to head in here. Okay, so I'm going to wait until the morning, if I can. Yes, there we go. Okay, so that seems good. That seems good. So now, ooh, this is going to be a little bit worrying, isn't it? Am I going to wait a little bit longer for our wound treatment to do its work? Maybe? Yes, okay, there we go. I think that's pretty good. No one else turned up. I'm kind of surprised about that, but hopefully they're going to sally out. No, they're not. Well, this is... Oh no, that's not going to go well, is it? No, okay, so I'm going to heal my forces just in case some of them still need a little bit of restoring. I don't know whether that actually makes any difference. I've never actually checked that. I don't think it does, but I'm going to do it anyway. It's only a very minor cost. Okay, so where are they? Okay, there's a slight issue. There is a slight issue with the trees, and the castle itself is floating. Yes, it's floating a little bit too much for my liking, so I'm not entirely sure if we will be able to do anything here. But I suppose we're seeing something that's rather unique, and I don't believe we've ever seen something like this ever before, so that's actually kind of cool. That is actually kind of cool, but yes, okay, well, this is interesting. Are we able to just move inside? I think there is a slight problem with the X or Y value of the placement of this particular castle, so yes, I'm not entirely sure if we'll actually be able to do anything here. If this castle acts in the exact same way that every other castle does, then obviously we'll be able to... Okay, it's not. It's not acting like every other castle. Well, this is interesting, and I don't have any other words for it, actually. Well, yes, a lot of the enemy's forces are just standing up there, not really. Oh, well, this is quite a predicament, isn't it? We're actually not able to do anything, so I, yeah. Well, there we go. I can't do anything else. Okay, so apparently we're going to have to head on to Agostine or something along those lines. Because apparently this is completely not possible unless we were to starve them out. That is the only way to take that. So, okay, well, I guess that's kind of good. It's kind of good that we get a different kind of attack going soon, I suppose, but yes, anyway, let's have a look here. 269, okay, so let's hope that this is a little bit more accessible. And we do have a vassal coming, I believe. But I did want to rest a little bit more, because we do have a couple that are still knocked unconscious, which is not good. Okay, so let's have a look here. Okay, so we're gaining some relations with all of the vassals that hate us, of course, and now we're going to lead our soldiers. Ah, this looks a little bit better. Okay, so we have a greater chance of taking this. Instead of 0%, we actually have, I don't know, a good chance, maybe 60% or so, of taking this. We are outnumbered almost, what is it, almost 3-1, basically. Oh no. Shield, save me. Yes, I need you to save me, please. Thank you very much. Okay, so this is going to be a time when I'm going to try and absorb damage. I'm going to try and absorb some damage, and then I'm going to use my Fearsome Cry. There we go, Fearsome Cry, and heal myself. There we go. So let's see if we can just get a couple more units in on the battlements, because that's exactly what we require to make some space. Yeah, there we go, there we go. Okay, some of them are floating around, some of them are dying in the most hilarious of ways. Yes, okay, so there we go. Let's kill them! Kill them all! Okay, so I'm taking a little bit too much damage for my liking, but I'm gonna try and get out of here and try and get some space. There we go. Okay, maybe I can now kill some of them. Yes. Okay, let's do some rage. Let us rage. Okay, so the rage is not helping. Okay, maybe if I think a little bit calmer and don't rage myself out, then I should be a little bit better. There we go, there we go. Nice. Okay, so now this is when I can heal my units. And the enemy has already received reinforcements. Wow, that's an ouch. That's an ouch for them, isn't it? Yes. That is a big ouch, because needing to receive reinforcements that quickly, that is certainly going to be a very painful experience. So, yes, speaking of experience, let's lose a little bit more experience points, because, of course, we do need to heal ourselves. Now, come on, come on, can you not kill those? Can you kill those, please? I don't want to fall off, because if I fall off, I'm probably going to die. Should I run around the side? Okay, I'm going to go and kill the crossbowmen. I'm just going to let my forces deal with the infantry on the enemy side, because, well, if I'm not going to do it, then no one's going to do it, so probably should go over here and take care of them. Oh, wow, there's actually a lot. There is actually a lot of them, okay. Need to be a little bit careful here, because I don't really want to be cornered, but I am moving into the corner, which is exactly what I wanted to do, not. So, yes, let's try and, yep, there we go, there we go. That's a lot better. Okay, so are you going to, oh, you're going to get out your crossbow. That was a huge mistake. Nice headshot. Diggory, good work. And, oh, is that it? Oh, okay. Well, yes. Diggory's just like, oh, is that it? I wished for more blood to spill. Yes, it's actually kind of hilarious considering, but I'm hoping that my forces are actually going to be able to push forward at some point, because it seems like they continually just get stopped by the reinforcements, so that's not a good sign, is it? Not really. So if I can take these guys out. There was a misguided thrust against him. Okay, I'm going to try and kick him. Kick him. Kick him. No, the kick is not working. Ah, the kick is not working. Okay, I'll just kill him the old-fashioned way then. I really wanted him to fall off. That would have been amazing. Okay, kill them. There we go. And are they going to get any more reinforcements for the crossbowmen? I don't think so. So I can just head down the stairs here. I need to be very careful of falling damage, obviously. So how many have we lost so far? We've lost actually quite a lot, and the enemy still actually has a good amount. So I'm going to have to be a little bit careful here. So I'm healing my troops for 39% of our hit points now. Why 39%? Why not 30? What happened? Did I increase a skill or something? I don't think so. I increased agility and... what was it? Horse riding. It wasn't actually anything to do with healing, so that's kind of a bit weird, but okay. I'm not complaining. It's perfectly fine. Let's get some rage going on here as well. Gonna need to kill these all in one hit so I can actually free up our units, because it seems like that was a huge error on my part to go after the crossbowmen, but even then, the crossbowmen are gonna deal a lot of damage, so I don't know what's better. Killing the infantry and freeing up our units? Probably. Oh well. Doesn't really matter so far, because we can kill all of these and then we can just make our presence known at the backs of our enemies. Oh, it seems like this is working quite nicely. Yes, there we go. Okay, so I'm going to try and use Fearsome Cry to disperse them so that we can actually get them on the stairs here. If we can get them on the stairs and push them back enough, we should be able to get an overwhelming advantage, and that will be how we will defeat them, of course, in this instance anyway. Okay, well, let's just behead a couple of other crossbowmen here. Yes. I do like the backhanded slash. The backhanded slash, usually, if you aim it correctly, will hit the enemy on its helmet, so that's usually a good idea. That's actually kind of nice. And the thrust is always good with a rapier, of course, as well. Does a lot of damage. I need to heal myself again. Ugh. Okay, so there we are. Healed our forces for 30% HP. Why not 39%? That's kind of weird. Oh, well. It was a bit of an anomaly there, apparently. Well, that's not too bad, I suppose. Okay, I'm drawing some of the fire, at least, but yeah, this is somehow... it might be a little bit risky. Oh, no, it's okay. It is okay. Okay, so let's just take out these guys, and then hopefully... is that it? I think that might actually be it. See, now, as soon as we got onto level ground with them, that is when the... well, kind of. That is when the casualties started to decrease. So I kind of like that. I kind of like that we made the wrong decision. Yeah, that was kind of the wrong decision right there to go after the crossbowmen. But I kind of thought to myself, well, if I'm not going to do it, no one else is. I mean, no one of my units, not one single unit decided, hey, you know what, I'm going to go over there. But yeah, I suppose I have killed them all, so it's kind of pointless for them to do that anyway. But yeah, well, whatever the case... I think we're fine, and there's level 33 for Diggory. Very nice. Okay, so, whoa, level 33 and 33 renown. Oh, well, there you go. A little bit of, well, relation there between the two numbers. Anyway, so we lost 22 of our forces, mainly due to my own ineptitude at deciding what I should be doing, and we gained some nice boots. There we go. That's some good boots right there. Okay, otherwise we can just let everything go. And I'm going to be giving this... I'm going to be giving it to someone. Yes, mark my words. I'm going to give this to someone. I'm going to give this to Anya, I believe. There we go. Now, everyone is not really happy with that, which is kind of a shame. But that's just how it goes. Now, this guy absolutely hates that. He is the pagan... well, technically the Norse pagan. He's our only pagan vassal, and he went down by -6. So I think we're probably going to be indicting him soon or something. I don't really want to, but it might be necessary for us to do that. So it's kind of a bit of a weird situation there. But anyway, that will be it for this episode. And next time, I'm not entirely sure, but I'm probably going to try and starve out this castle before I start recording, and then we'll see where it goes from there. But anyway, I thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next time.